AWARD is a career development program that is investing in the top African women scientists, driving innovation in the agricultural sector. And the idea is, our dream is really for an Africa that can feed itself. And that we have African women research scientists who are part of the community of innovators, an active part of the community of innovators that are driving solutions for this challenge, for the challenge that the continent is facing. Your audience might know that the African continent is going to need to increase food production by about 260% by the year 2050 to meet the food needs of this continent. And that's a daunting task that's really going to require all hands on deck. And what we're doing as AWARD and as part of moving Africa towards meeting that goal, that ambitious goal, is making sure that we've got the research scientists who are making innovative contributions to those challenges. Well, women, we're not going to be able to feed Africa with women at the margins. If you look at who's on the farms today, we've got women are a majority of who grows and feeds Africa at the moment. At the same time, we've got a massive imbalance where we've got women farming, but we've got women vastly underrepresented in the ARD end, the agricultural research and development end of the spectrum. That end of this value chain, women are vastly underrepresented. Where we've got only one in four research scientists on the African continent is a woman. And when it comes to decision making, the numbers are really depressing. You've got only one in seven of the decision makers in agricultural research and development who's a woman. That means when we sit at a table and we're trying to make decisions about how we're gonna feed this continent, only one of the seven participants at that table is a woman. The primary thing that AWARD does is run an internationally recognized fellowship program that again is working with the top women scientists from across Sub-Saharan Africa. If you want to use the imagery of the traditional African stool, our fellowship program stands on three legs. First is mentoring. We know that professionals, but especially women, do much better when they are in a community of excellence. So we've got a mentoring program that really that is a nurturing community of excellence for our emerging women scientists. We have got leadership skills training where we'll see that sometimes you'll have a woman who's got all the scientific training, her science is absolutely solid, but for her to end up heading her department, heading her research institution, and really stepping into those decision-making roles, that we need to make some extra investments. And we've got to be intentional in making sure that the women who do make it to the decision-making table have the skills, the network that comes from the mentoring, but also the skills, the leadership skills, whether it's negotiation skills, right, whether it's how to manage people, how to manage cultural diversity in the workplace. Those are really important factors and elements. And then finally, the science skills. As a continent, we're going to need really sharp science skills. And the third leg of the stool, that is the AWARD Fellowship Program, focuses on building African women scientists' science skills. We've got a community of over 800 scientists from across Sub-Saharan Africa. We've supported 390 English-speaking fellows, and we've got a growing community of Francophone fellows. Absolutely. And some of the work that we're doing at AWARD is actually working with institutions, deploying our fellowship model, which we often call the empowerment model, to institutions. We've been running a couple of pilot programs where we invest in the leadership of institutions, understanding the best ways to unlock the talent that they already have within those institutions, right? So, and where, you know, you could have a hammer approach where it's like, hey, you know, you must open doors for women. Or have you thought about you're missing out on so much innovation, so much new research could be happening at your institution if we worked with you to restructure and build a system that works, and if it works for women, it will work for the men as well. I absolutely think that the AWARD model and similar programs do ease the challenge of brain drain. If you look at the mentoring element of our work, what we're doing is showing emerging scientists that it is possible to be successful and effective on the continent. So when your mentor is the head of a research institution here on the continent, is someone who has grown up in a context similar to yours, and you're able to see the ways that they're driving change for the continent, that they're having real impact, that I think does a lot more for addressing the push factors of brain drain. But at the same time, there are certain skills that need to be global, that have been concentrated in the West, and that need to get diffused. And so as part of our science work, the science skills building, we do send our fellows abroad. We've got beautiful partnerships with organizations like NOVAS, right, with universities around the world, really, and then bring them back home, right? And so we're working with fellows who are really committed to the continent, who have commitments, especially to smallholder farmers, and we build up their skills so that they can succeed on the continent. And I think that really does help address the issue of brain drain. The first thing that comes to mind is the people, the over 800 scientists who are part of this community. At the end of the day, you can look at AWARD as having created a movement. Really, across Sub-Saharan Africa, there's over 800 scientists who are passionate about driving innovation in the agricultural sector so that Africa can feed itself. That didn't exist before AWARD. We've got networks. These scientists are connected to each other. They're in a powerful network where they can reach to each other and cross-fertilize ideas, if you will. Absolutely optimistic. Absolutely optimistic. You know, The Economist a couple of years ago, the first they had the Africa, the dark continent, as the cover feature. And recently they've had to go back and reevaluate and well, things are going on this continent. And looking at the agricultural sector, I am just thrilled, and I consider myself lucky to be on the planet at this moment in history. In really, really important ways, this is Africa's century. And not just when it comes to natural resources, but for agriculture, because we're truly revolutionizing the way farming has been done and the way that we're feeding ourselves as a continent. This may be a strong statement, but I really believe that Africa is not going to be able to solve Africa's food challenge purely through imported solutions. We need to grow, develop, strengthen, and heavily network our brains, Africa's top agricultural brains. And that's what AWARD is doing. The solutions for Africa's food challenges, a lot of them lie in Africa. And so increasing the number of PhDs, especially making sure that women are part of that, that women, African women, are a full 50% of the human resource that we put into this challenge is going to be absolutely critical. There's no other way to do it. We've been dependent for too long, and now we really get to solve this in this generation. That is the daunting task ahead of us. In this generation, we must find a solution for Africa's food challenges.